Action.
Action. Well, like I was saying, you don't just fold it over. You've got to make sure you fold it kind of, like you can't really rub it in either direction. You have to fold it where it, pretty much 90 degrees to where it was.
Okay.
And then sort of, because it's rounded, there'll be puckers in it, and you just sort of have to work those. Work those out.
Okay, so it's like massaging the cloth to flat.
Yeah, so like here, I can't tension this and fold it. I have to bring it 90 degrees where it was.
Okay.
And there will be these puckers.
Yeah.
And it's not as apparent here, but like here, for example.
Okay.
That goes there and this pucker forms.
Yeah.
You just have to sort of make it disappear in evenly in between these folds.
You're averaging out the puckers.
Exactly. And that way you don't get these diagonal wrinkles all up the luff.
Okay. Oh, so that'll affect the final sail shape.
It'll, it may not affect the shape as much, but it'll look really bad.
Okay.
It'll sort of, if the effect it would have is it could, like, corkscrew the luff.
Oh, weird.
The tension would be all off.
Hmm. All right.
So that's the other thing, is when you're folding this, you want the wrinkles out of the sail, but you don't want to load up on it. You don't want to tension it. What we will do. Are you charging right now? Or are you?
Yeah, I've got the camera plugged in.
Okay.
Do you need a?
I need a cord.
All right. Let's see. I can unplug it.
Just for a minute, if you wouldn't mind.
This is the only cord that's going.
Oh wait, you might be. In
oh, there you go. Sweet. If that's
yeah, this one's already
usable.
Plugged in.
Okay, there you go. So
you
even
keep
better.
You keep your charging station.
My power hungry.
Keep your power. I don't need it.
Oh yeah, this is warming up.
Yeah.
So what is this, lox and cream cheese?
It's, one of them's tomato and chive. One of them is plain.
Gotcha. Yeah, this is the tomato.
Up a little bit. Yeah, they make good stuff.
Yeah, it looks like it.
So this one. This one's easy, we just pin that out. We'll see how we do with your height here. I might have to cut into another one. That's really good. Let that heat up, and I'm going to cut into another. Take it out real quick, get another half going. Got onion, asiago, everything. For a good snack, though.
Mm-hmm.
When I was on the boat, I was a student, but like student employee.
Mm-hmm.
When we were underway and like on shore, when we were in shipyard, we got a $20 food stipend per person per day.
Mm.
$20 per person per day, but we were hauled out, so we didn't really have any galley access.
Mm.
It was all, we had like one extension cord that we all had to share. So most of our food had to be eaten out or purchased, you know, like.
$20 isn't going to go far if you're eating out.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
So we got smart.
Mm-hmm.
A shipmate and I pulled our $20.
Okay.
We spent $12 on a dozen day olds. So for 6 days we would have breakfast and lunch was bagels.
Oh my gosh.
But you know, like PB&J for lunch and
yeah.
cream cheese for breakfast.
Oh, neat.
Get our coffee from the Circle K.
Okay.
And then the other, that was 24 bucks, or no, it was 12 bucks. So combined we had 38 bucks. No, like 28 bucks left for dinner every day.
Wow.
Between the two of us, and we could make that work.
So what would you get for dinner?
We're the local Rockland Cafe. We would go there. Food was cheap. Or we go get prepared food from a cafe or something that was cheap. I was like, a week and a half of that, though. It was a hard yard period. Between four of us, we got three coats on the boat. No, two whole coats. Top side on the boat in one day.
Wow.
Which was insane.
Hell week. Wow.
I don't think my schooner idea is going to work. Too big to fail, though. Too big to fail. This iron is for the glue. When the glue is hot, it sticks better. Same thing. You don't wanna work it towards one end. You wanna start. You wanna press down at random increments. Smush it because this is all open, unglued. So you can't two rows of glue to really secure it.
Ooh, okay. So, yeah, alright. So you're doubling up glue on all of the loose edges?
Yeah, so on this first seam it's not as important, but for the next row I'm going to do, I don't really need to, but I'm going to do glue twice. Glue as well, you want to be fairly equal tension. Do a nice long runs by this, reaching out as far as you can, and just maintaining that tension. You can tack it down. Now instead of 10 little, 10 runs of glue, 10 short runs with varying tensions, I have 4 large runs with probably equal tension because I did less.
Longer stretches.
Yeah, so if I did little 1-foot stretches the whole way, the tension would be the same, but probably not. It would be varying.
Gotcha,
as opposed to 4 big ones. This. Do it like 4 feet at a time instead of one. And you can maintain the tension that you put on the glue better.
Now the glue is stretchy or is it just the The backing isn't stretchy, but the glue itself is.
The glue can be. The release paper is not stretchy. The white stuff isn't, but the glue itself.
Fairly flexible.
Is fairly flexible. Yeah, you can roll it up in a ball. You can stretch it.
Mm.
It's a lot like double sided Scotch tape.
Yeah.
But
okay.
But it has a much weaker structure.
Mm.
As you can see, it can be a pain sometimes.
Yeah. And it comes with the territory, I guess.
It does.
Yeah, but once you get it started, then it's just an easy.
Uh-huh.
You walk it off.
Exactly. But you see how it all peeled up just now. It's not even sticking.
It's almost like it likes to grab on the ends.
Yeah, it's not ideal. Mm-hmm. But that's why we iron it. It's because it's more inclined to stick. Same thing. It's more inclined to stick to this.
Oh gosh, now this is probably twice as hard to not get any wrinkles in this, or is it easier at this point? Because it's more structured. It's less likely to wrinkle.
About the same. See, there's light wrinkles forming there.
Okay.
But under strain,
you
won't see them.
Yeah.
It is under a little more tension, though, here.
Okay.
Like, it wants to pop up, which is why you want to kind of do this quick. And then, like, the sooner you can get the iron on it, the better.
Mm-hmm.
So this is what I'm talking about here.
Yeah, sure.
The stitching will work those little ones out, but if you get your tensions wrong, it'll look like that, but aggressively the whole way down. And it'll still work. It'll still sail.
Yeah. But
eventually they might even work out. But the customer is not always thrilled.
Oh gosh.
By that.
Well, I'll tell you, I do want to be a thrilled customer, so.
Yeah. You'll have to find, you'll have to subcontract a different sale maker. He doesn't like this.
Oh wow.
I'll be out of a job.
Yeah, so I was ended up getting into a pretty good chat with George over there, and I was telling him about, you know, I'm hoping to get the boat in the water by lunar fast.
Mm-hmm.
So it's looking like you may even have a spot for me to or for Pike to tie up, you know, this Alpha Dory beside my boat.
That's good.
Which would be kind of ideal for him. He can launch for the, you know, for the entire week, and then maybe even test out whatever sort of sleeping arrangement for the rig on the boat.
Where would he put in?
Well, depends if he wants to sail over or if he just wants to paddle over. We could put in that Parker River where I'll probably be launching Centennial. Or he could put in over at a Rocky Neck Accommodations and just slowly dip his way over, you know.
We can't make it 3 inches bigger.
Okay.
I realize it's gotta be the all or nothing. We can't sneak it in on another side. It will be per the... Unfortunately, it's going to be per the plans this time.
Unfortunately. No, that's fine.
We'll do another sail. We'll go do a second.
A racing sail.
A top sail.
Oh my gosh, even better.
We'll do a top.
I'll have to make a topmast for it.
For your extra panel? You need a topmast? I got the, I know a guy with a mop handle.
Wow. I'm still thinking about a square sail for some time. That downwind work.
Should probably start letting the wind still die out, right? Down to the last 30 minutes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so. Plenty of warm up here, huh? If we start getting chilled, we can put our coats back on.
That's what I was thinking. I usually start to wind it down in the last half hour.
Oh my gosh, yeah.
This is our leech, our hollow.
Get to those Caledonia yawls or whatever else, go to island skiffs and all, we'll be shaking our fist. Curse you, John, we don't have those extra 3 inches. But then when the breeze gets up and we're peeled over with the rail going under, we'll be like, wow, we would have swamped if it weren't for John. It's 3 inch smaller.
He's building his underbelt.
Yeah. Turns out you knew what you were doing after all.
I
prevented a capsize.
Around here, I always felt it was better to be able to stop than to go faster.
Makes a lot of sense.
Because in Gloucester Harbor, no one else will.
Mm-hmm.
No one else will stop, I mean.
Mm-hmm.
So with that being said, if you can... avoid a collision by stopping.
Mm-hmm.
You can't do that with a fast boat.
Right.
That's why I cut my mast in half.
Mm-hmm.
No one's gonna get out of Mugatu's way. Gotta be able to stop.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm.
So here's another trick.
Okay.
Which I'm not doing. If you want to get, if you're doing something like this and you want to, your sail, your edge has a lot of shape, but you don't want to wrestle with that shape,
mm-hmm.
you put a flake in the sail, this, all the way down,
right.
And that takes all the shape in the sail, sucks it up into the flake, and so you may have an inch and a half of round,
mm-hmm.
but while you're working with it, it's completely flat.
Mm.
And that's so that you don't have to wrestle with that shape. The shape disappears.
Oh, man.
That's a sail-making trick, so you don't have to fight with it.
Cool. good. Oh. Let's see how we're doing on. Good. Yeah, can't beat the view for sail making, that's for sure. If you need any inspiration, just have a look out the windows. You're gazing on the launching ways of schooners like Columbia and Adventure. I'll just tell Pike, sorry, it's a rowboat. The sail got pickled.
I'm doing.
Oh, very cool. You doing like a micro fold or a...
The nature of this, the leech usually has one fold for our sails because I don't want hinging.
Yeah. Good bagels.
They are, I like Jim's. This is
John's grumbling, not a good sign.
Not a bad sign, just an extra step. Yeah, no, somehow that looks worse, so we're not going to do that. I don't think this is going to be an issue.
Okay.
I'm going to do a double fold on the stern as well.
Could you do a half a fold, or is that too much of a...
I would rather, the bigger the fold, the less likely it is to hinge.
Oh, okay. Alright.
Mm-hmm. One of two things should have happened.
Okay.
This should have been hot knifed and thus a raw edge, which it was not.
Okay.
Or we do some kind of small, and the short answer is we're too far along to go back.
Could you just go with a raw edge?
Yeah. And
sew along that edge. Like, I don't think it's going to tatter a lot.
It won't.
It'll
the
fuzz
glue,
a little.
It'll fuzz a little, and the glue, it'll stop at the glue.
Yeah.
And the glue is, like, this, like, a millimeter in.
Yeah. Is that an option? Because that, like, you know, to me, it looks gorgeous as is.
Okay.
And, you know, a sail with a little bit of feel to it, some hand, if there's a little...
Yeah.
You know,
It'll buzz a little bit and it'll stop.
This material is very good at not fraying. Is like kind of, you know. Like, well, I don't think it's going to turn into like a pair of ripped jeans.
Well,
you know,
none of the sails have any raw edges. That's why you see it never fraying.
Yeah.
Because
true.
I know all of this.
True. Sure, you got a point. Yeah, it's up to you. But that's my initial thought. Maybe. Because I think that run of thread is gonna really prevent that run of stitches. So could you do like a double row of stitching along that fire edge and then?
It would fray through it.
Really?
Yeah. Usually hot knife. I don't like hot knife.
Yeah. All right. Now this is hot knife. Is that why this edge here? Is that why this is okay?
Correct. Okay. You know what? Here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna undo it.
Finding out why you get paid the big bucks. I like it.
I'm gonna take it a step further. Watch this. Crazy John.
Yeah, look at that. So you're basically splitting the tape that was there in half,
yeah.
Putting it on itself, and then re-taping it. Right.
I'm reefing and caulking at the same time.
Cool.
To give you some kind of...
Something that I could relate to.
Yeah, I'm reefing with my arms and caulking with my knees.
Cool.
Fraying edges for pipe. This way he doesn't lose.
Yeah. No, it's gonna be
any.
No, this is, I like this.
This is a half inch fold,
mm-hmm.
Which means we just make the leech fold
okay.
A half inch behind that line instead of on the line.
Alright.
You don't have to measure that. Can measure that, but half inches.
Tiny.
Yeah.
As far as the wind goes, the wind and the wave isn't going to care for a half inch one way or the other.
Yes.
Maybe someone who's overly enthusiastic might, but the sea isn't going to run.
You won't have fraying now.
Yeah, well, that's great.
Nice, tidy, finished edge.
Yeah.
I couldn't live with it, is what the conclusion was.
You're not gonna compromise the quality.
Yeah, I'm not gonna look at a sail with raw edges and go, yes, I built
that. Oh, man. This is going to be great.
This is much better. For all intents and purposes, I could just go off the old fold.
Yeah.
It's already ironed.
No, it's perfect. It's a nice light edge.
To waste it, you know?
No, and it's a nice crisp trailing edge to that sail, so the wind's just going to love that as it, you know, kind of slides off the back edge of the leech of the sail. Oh, my gosh. Yeah, so I'm actually... going to do some Norwegian splices on the rigging for this. We're gonna go with wire rigging, but it's gonna be all spliced eyes rather than the just the swaged ends.
Norwegian. Is Norwegian the new French?
Basically.
You know how you want, like, back in the day, you wanted things to sound fancy, so, like in sewing, it was like, oh, it's a French seam.
Okay.
You know, or like, yeah. What kind of coffee is that? Oh, you know, is that pressed coffee? Oh, no, it's French press. It sounds much fancier if you put French in front of it. Like, where's the toilet? Oh, you mean the French toilet. And you're like, oh, wow.
It smells better already.
Yeah, exactly. Just the fact that it's French is like, oh, okay, wow. Ooh, ooh la la. So I'm wondering if Norwegian, especially with the hype of, like, you know, Norway and Iceland as travel destinations,
yeah,
is the new French.
Oh my gosh. Here's hoping. Because that'll just be right on the cusp of a trend here with the stays that I'm going to be making.
Yeah, well, especially in boat building, we've got fairings and all sorts of...
Oh, exactly. Yeah, I better get in on that action.
Norse